sound system producing 835 watts. Mark Levins will also be present tomorrow at the Colony, and be sure to check them out. They have a sound room, and also we'll spend some time with you in the vehicle to really get you to experience that if you haven't already. Mark Levins, of course, recently introduced on our RC was the clarified technology, which takes that compressed music and actually reproduces it and brings it back to CD quality. So it's quite the treat for those of you that are audiophiles out there. Standard on the RX is now a power rear door, and in the insert here, we're showing the two-touch feature to that. So you can actually do a double tap on the rear door to close it, and it'll close the door and also lock the vehicle all in one fell swoop. Currently, you'd have to hit the button, then use the remote touch to lock the vehicle. So again, just taking it to the next level. And speaking of taking it to the next level, the RX also features a touch-free power rear door. The upper portion of the emblem, you can hold your hand over top of it as long as you've got the key in your possession, and you'll hear a chime, move your hand away, and the door will rise. The beauty of that is if the vehicle is dirty, someone doesn't have to get their hands dirty, or if you even have your hands full, you don't need to just use your hand. You can actually use an elbow, other things of that nature. I was joking with somebody that you can even use your forehead, and he tried it, and said, aren't you glad I wasn't pulling one on you? So it's a unique feature, and I think very innovative. Also, to bring the outside in, we now have a panoramic moonroof. The opening angle, the opening has actually been moved 10 millimeters forward, so that way it allows the driver to get a little more of the outside in. So several of the vehicles. It features a rolling screen, so again, operation of that is seamless. Rear seat entertainment, everything's gotten bigger in the RX. The RX itself, the nav screens up front, even our rear seat entertainment, it now features 11.6-inch LCD displays that have in-plane switching, so increased viewing angles are offered by that in-plane switching, as well as they are tiltable, so we can actually get the perfect viewing position. And also connectivity has been increased in the sense that it offers an HDMI port in the back, as well as a 120-volt plug with rear seat entertainment. Our telematics system has actually seen an addition to it. Last year, we brought aboard Lexus Informed Remote, which gave guests the ability to lock and unlock car through remote engine start. Now we have Service Connect. This feature is actually going to, we believe, bring our guests and their dealers closer, because the guests will be able to know what's going on with their vehicle health report. They'll be provided maintenance alerts, as well as vehicle alerts if anything should arise. The dealer will have the ability to actually reach out to the guest if the guest chooses and schedule maintenances for the guest, which we believe is going to be a nice feature for that kind of, again, taking it to the next level of service and get. Safety System Plus, Lexus Safety System Plus, features four new systems, or pre-existing systems bundled together. We see the addition of all-speed dynamic radar cruise control, allowing the driver to have far, mid, and near settings. The vehicle will automatically maintain that preset driving distance, but if the vehicle in front actually were to come to a stop, it will stop as well. So again, convenience for the driver. It also, when that vehicle does come to a stop, to restart, you'll see waiting showing up in your display. You'll actually use the cruise control stalk to resume, or else step on the accelerator pedal, and all speed dynamic radar cruise control will re-engage. Pre-collision system with pedestrian detection has been added. One thing too, the all speed dynamic radar cruise control and several of these other systems, we're now making use of a monocular camera that's embedded in behind the rearview mirror, so it's reading the road ahead, as well as making use of the millimeter wave radar technology. Pre-collision uses the millimeter wave radar. Again, if there is an imminent collision, they're first warned with an audible and a visual and a multi-information display to get the driver's attention, and hopefully they'll react. If they don't, it does feature automatic braking as well. And pedestrian detection has been added, utilizing the monocular camera in that sense. Lane Keep Assist uses the monocular camera reading the line. requires a dynamic radar cruise control to be turned on and active, and then that's when the system will actually be able to control the steering. It is not autonomous. It will sense if a driver has taken a hand off the wheel for an extended period, and it'll be activated itself. So it's not, you know, suddenly the car takes over and just does its own driving. You get to experience that tomorrow on one of the drive routes. With lane keep assist, sway warning has been added as well. This is looking at the driver's behavior within the lines. If they seem to be kind of doing a little sway, maneuvering back and forth repeatedly, or if there's any erratic maneuver that the driver does, it'll actually illuminate this coffee cup to give the guest, you know, kind of an idea, like maybe time to stop and get a little break. You see that little bar at the bottom, time to rest. That bar will actually, you know, continue as the driver winds up having some issues. It'll minimize that. Eventually, that coffee cup will illuminate and say, time to stop. And then intelligent high beams. Once you've activated the high beams, it looks at preceding traffic or oncoming traffic with dim to low beam. And then as soon as that object passes, it'll put the high beams back on. Also, of course, it looks at ambient lights. So street lights over the top or a well-lit area, it'll automatically dim the lights. That's Lexus Safety System Plus. We also now, of course, have blind spot monitor with rear cross traffic alert. Within rear cross traffic alert, we can actually turn that off now in the MID display. So you can have just blind spot monitor alone, blind spot monitor with rear cross traffic alert, or you can turn both of the features off. We also have now a panoramic view monitor utilizing four cameras on the vehicle, one in the front grille, one on each side with side mirrors, and then the backup camera. It stitches together these images and gives you a bird's eye view to let the driver know kind of what's around them, enhancing safety. You can also cycle through and have where it shows you just the parallel to the vehicle. So if you're trying to get into a parking space or if you're in a tight, constricted area, get a sense of the surroundings with that. Also, once it's activated and start up, you'll find it on the left side of the dash, the button for that kind of looks like a camera. Tap it, and it'll actually give you like a neat 360 animated view, and then cycle up over top of it. I was mesmerized for a while when I first got to play around with the car, so it's a really kind of cool technology that I think we're going to see guests find very useful. Airbags, 10 airbags are standard in the RX. The driver airbag, front passenger airbag is a twin chamber airbag that we continue to use. Driver knee airbag, for the passenger side, it's a seat cushion airbag that we first saw introduced in our NX that makes its way to the RX. Because the glove box is larger now too, so we've removed the knee airbag